We copy paste the program. So look at the structure, everyone. I'm creating a batch example. Database got batchable. Can I create a constructor? Can I create a constructor? Yes, 100% we can create. Now I'm giving a global batch. Then I am creating a start method. Batchable context. Then we have s dot put. Now if you remember well, we have discussed a point. We want to insert acc dot put name pro. You remember this format what we discussed? There are three ways. Now I have taken this put field name comma value because I'm not sure which field you are giving. If you provide a name, I might have given s dot name equal to so and so. I am not sure which field you are giving. So s dot put field name comma value update. Global. This is a regular batch apex what we have created. Regular batch apex. Now I am creating one more batch apex. I'm getting one more batch of this. Let me make it straight. Batch of x1, batch of x2. Now the question is, can I call batch of x from another batch of x? If you want to call a batch of x from another batch of x, what should I do? This is how we are going to give. Now I am giving this within the start method. Can I call a batch of x from another batch of x from start method or not? I am trying to invoke batch of x from another batch of x from start method. Now what it is giving? Constructor not defined, because here it is expecting value of query. I'll do one thing. I'll invoke this from another so that it will be easy for me. So no issue. You're supposed to pass worry. Field name. Now, I am calling a batch of x from another batch of x from the start method. I am calling a batch of x from another batch of x from the start method. Execute it. Execute it. Trying to call a batch of x from another batch of x. See what is the outcome of it. Now, Apache jobs. Error. Database.execute batch cannot be called from start, execute, or future method. So you will not be able to call a batch of x from start method of a batch of x, or execute method of a batch of x, or a future method. Batch of x cannot be called from start method of a batch of x, execute method of a batch of x, or from a future method. I cannot call a batch of x from a future method. I hope you are good. Fine. They told start method, execute method, but they didn't mention finish method. They told batch of x cannot be called from another batch of x for my start or execute. They didn't mention anything about finish. That means we'll be able to call batch of x from where? Batch of x from where? We'll be able to call batch of x from, we'll be able to call batch of x from finish method. Now go back to this. Now whatever I gave, can disconnect it. Go to finish method. So I am calling from a finish method. Why I am calling from a finish method? When does the finish is called? When the first batch is completed. Start completed, all the executes are completed, then I am coming to finish. The phase, first batch is completed. When the first batch is completed, then only I am coming to the finish. So we can call batch of x from another batch of x from finish method. I can call batch of x from another batch of x from batch of x from another batch of x from finish method. Go back and see what happened. Both the operations are So can I call a batch of x from another batch of x? 100%, but only from finished method. Only from finished method. Can I call a future method in the batch of x? No. You cannot call a future method from start method or execute method or finish method. Can I call schedule fx from a start method or execute method or finish method? No. You cannot call future, you cannot call queueable, you cannot call schedulable from batch fx. From batch fx you cannot call future, schedule, queueable or batch. In the finish method of batch, you can call batch fx. I hope you are good with this. Clear for everyone? Batch can be called from batch only from finish method. Batch can be called from only batch from finish method. I hope everyone is good. Clear? Right, boss? Okay. Next point. Can I call a batch fx within the schedule fx? Yes. We can call a batch fx within a schedule fx. Now look at this. Why don't we? Can a class implement more than one interface? Yes, right? Let me write the schedule also here. So this class is implementing database.batchable as well as schedulable. If it is implementing a schedulable, what should I do? Execute. Within this, I'm calling a batch fx. From schedule fx, can I call a batch fx? 100%. Most of the times, it is a combination of schedule fx and batch fx. Most of the time, both will be running together. Because generally, when you go for batch fx, bulk data. When you go for batch fx, bulk data. Bulk data means large amount of data. Large amount of data. If you are working with a large amount of data, generally what we do? We will do the operation on nightly basis. If you are working with a larger set of data, generally what we do? We will do a nightly job. That is the reason batch fx and schedule fx most of the times will run together. Are you getting my point? Can I call a batch fx from a schedule fx? 100% you can call. No issue with that. Okay. Now, if I am giving the schedule fx, I will give a time trigger. Cron trigger I will give. What is that? Run this job on every Friday. Run this job on 10th of this month, like that. I don't want to run it after, run every day. I don't want to run after every month. I want to run only once. After 5 minutes, I want this job to run. I want this job to run how many times? Only once. When you want the job to run? After 5 minutes. Then how will you define? If you want the batch job to run only once, then also after 5 minutes, now we have system dot schedule batch. Generally, how do you schedule? System dot schedule is for scheduling the apex class. But if you want to schedule a batch job once, I can go with this. What was that? Look at the point. System dot schedule batch. What is the object? B is the object. What is the name of the job? Some name you give. Now, after how much time? 5 minutes from now. What is the size of the batch? Now, once again, system dot schedule batch. Which job you want to run? Some batch. What is that B1? Object of the apex class. Name of the job? Right. Then after how many minutes? I want to run after 60 minutes. Now you are not giving the scope. Then what is the size? 200. If you don't define the size of the batch, what is the size? 200. Now, name object of the class, name of the job, after how many minutes? This will run the batch fx only once after 60 minutes. that will run the batch once only once after 5 minutes. If you give the size, it's okay. If you don't give the size, 200. I hope you're good. You can schedule the job only once, or you can schedule the job recursively. If you want to schedule the job recursively, what should I do? If you want to schedule the job recursively, then it has to be, written within the execute method of the batch, execute method of the schedule batch. Now you want this batch to run only once, then system.schedule batch. I hope you are good with this. Let's get into the next concept. That is extension. What is this extension? Why you want to go for this extension? Extensions means, till today we have used either a standard controller or we have used a controller. We have not used both of them together. Either we have used a standard controller or we have used a controller. We have not used both of them together. But now I want to use both of them together. Why? I want to replace some of the standard functionalities on the standard pages. I want to create some custom buttons or custom links on the standard pages. Whatever the standard pages are there, on the standard pages, I want to replace with my custom logic. The standard pages, I want to replace with my custom logic. If you want to replace the standard buttons or pages with your custom pages, I need to go for extension. Why? Look at this. Everyone follow these points. I have account. I have a new button. When I click on the new button, I don't want this page. I want this page to be modified. Right now, accounts tab, new button. Who created this new button? Salesforce has created. Who defined this page? Salesforce has defined. I want to replace this page with my custom logic. Then how do you do it? Boss, if you want to create any new button on account, or if you want to replace any one of the existing functionality on the account, then VF page should have standard controller as account. If you are trying to create any new button or trying to replace any one of the existing functionalities on standard page, if you want to create any new buttons, or you want to replace any one of the existing functionality on any object, that object should be taken as a standard controller. Then only we can replace it. Look at the point. No. I'm taking this. Why I'm taking standard? I want to replace those functionality, I'm taking a standard. Then I have we had. Now, action, basic program boss, this is the first 1 week classes, the first 1 week we have learned about how to refer to standard controller, create a button, create page block buttons, create a page block section. We have seen all these things. We have then I'm giving one more page block section. They give ready type. Now I have created this VF page. Go to the VF page. This is the VF page what I create. What I want to do is, when I click on the new, I don't want this page, I want that page to come. The VF page what I created, that should be open. When I click on new, I don't want the standard page, I want this page to be open. When I click on new, I don't want the standard page, I want this custom page to be open. Then how will you do that? So go back to this. So what is your intention? You want to replace the new button, standard Salesforce given new button, you want to replace with your custom Visual Force. So what I was doing is setup, build, customize, then we have accounts. In the accounts we have buttons and links. Customize, accounts, buttons and links. What is the button we got? Click on edit, override, classic override, standard button we are replacing with custom. Now why only these pages are coming? We have written a lot of Visual Force pages, right? We have written a lot of Visual Force pages, but only these 5 pages are coming. Why only 5 pages are coming? Because only these 5 pages have standard controller equal to account. If you want to replace any one of the standard functionality on account, we can only replace with those Visual Force pages which have standard controller equal to account. If I want to go with a contact, if I want to replace any functionality on the contact, I can only go with those Visual Force pages which have standard controller equal to contact. Are you getting? If you want to replace any one of the standard buttons or pages, we can only replace with those Visual Force pages which have their object given as standard controller. Because I am trying to override the account, these pages have account object as standard controller. Now what I give? Account, new page. Then go back, click on new button. What happened? My custom page opened. When you click on the new button, standard page is removed, my custom page came. Now I was giving here. When I click on save, it is saving the record. Now according to my requirement, when I click on the save, it should not save the record. It has to verify, are there any duplicate records? If there are no duplicate records, then it has to check. What is the standard functionality of save? standard functionality of save is, standard functionality of save is directly save the record. But what is your business requirement? When you click on the save, it should not save. When I click on the save, it has to verify, are there any duplicate records? If there are any duplicate records, it has to throw error message. If there are no duplicate records, it has to save. Now, the saving of the records should be done if there are no duplicate records. Saving of the records should be done if there are no duplicate records. What is my requirement? Save the record only if there is no duplicate. So before saving the record, I want to check, are there any duplicate records? Before saving the record, I want to check, are there any duplicate records? Are you getting my point? This is standard functionality? No. What is standard functionality? Straight away save it. What is my functionality? I want the duplicate should be verified. So I want the standard controller. Some of the functionalities I want to modify as per my requirement. I want to use standard functionalities only. I want to use standard functionalities only, but in some of the places, whichever I don't like, I want to replace with my custom functionality. So what we are doing? Standard controller extending custom functionality. Standard controller functionalities are coming. We are extending to custom functionality. So if you want standard controller and custom controller to be taken together, if you want standard controller and custom controller to be taken together, we go for a concept called extension. Standard controller extends custom controller. So standard properties extends custom properties. Standard controller extends custom controller. Standard controller extends custom controller. What does it mean? I want the standard properties plus some custom properties. Then what will I do? Then we have to define an Apex class which can be used as an extension. If you want to use any Apex class as an extension, if you want to use any Apex class as an extension, let us see this. I want to use this Apex class as extension. Straight away I cannot give it. Straight away I cannot give it. If I give it, throws error message. I told standard controller extensions account. What is the error we are receiving here? Constructor not found. Why? Generally, if you are defining any Apex class as a controller, then it requires no parameters in the constructor. Am I right? Any Apex class which does not have any parameters in the constructor, I can use them as a controller in the VFPH. If I want to use any class in the VFPH, the class should not contain any parameters in the constructor. But in this case, if you want to define any Apex class as an extension, it should contain parameter. If you want to define any Apex class as an extension, it should contain constructor with parameter. What was that? Look at this. If you want to use any Apex class as a extension, the class should contain constructor with parameter. Which parameter? Apex pages dot standard controller or Apex pages dot standard set controller. When I say Apex pages dot standard controller, Whichever the record we are referring, that record will come here. Are you getting my point? So if you want to define any Apex class as an extension, the constructor should have Apex pages dot standard controller or Apex pages dot standard set controller as parameter.
If you want to use any Apex class as an extension, that Apex class should have constructor with parameter. What parameter? Apex pages dot standard controller or Apex pages dot standard set controller. I hope you are good with this. Okay. Now, what this standard controller is referring? Whichever the record you are referring in the VF page, the same record will be given here. Whichever the record you are referring in the VF page, the same record will be used here. What I was giving here. Look at the point. Public account ACC set. Now I'm giving ACC equal to. Now this standard controller is taking the data in the form of S object. Why? You may use standard controller there as account. You may use a standard controller as a contact. You may use a standard controller as an opportunity. You may use a standard controller as a customer. I am not sure which object you are going to use as a standard controller. Then what is the choice I have? I have to take S object. If I am not sure about which object you are going to get, I will take S object. If I am taking S object, what I was supposed to do? Convert that S object into virtual form. Controller dot get. When I say controller dot get record, get me the record that standard controller is referring. In the VF page, you are referring to some record, right? Whichever the record you are referring in the VF page, whichever the record you are referring in the VF page, give me that record. Whichever the record you are giving in the VF page, give me that record. Whichever the record you are referring in the VF page, give me that record. Controller dot get record. The record which you are referring in the VF page that we are able to get it here. Then, what I want to do here? I want to apply my own functionality. Public void save. When I wrote public void save, standard functionality of save is not employed. This save will be running. When I say save method, it will not call the standard functionality. Previously, when I call the save, standard save method is called. But now what is happening? Custom save. What I want to do? Integer. Count equal to. If count is greater than 0, what does it mean? If count is greater than 0, there is a duplicate record. Then I have to give apex page dot else, you should ACC. Set ID from account where name equal to. Then I'm giving here this, what we put. Now what happened? I'm trying to create. duplicate record for. Record is, I hope you are good with this. Right. Now if you observe, right. So you are trying to take the data. Generally look at the point. Whatever the data we are entering in the VF page, what is it is saved to the, that is coming to the controller. Whatever the data we entered in the VF page, we are getting that record as a controller. Convert that controller into account, then write your logic. So from the VF page, we are taking that record as a controller and extending our logic with the Apex programming. So what was this? Standard controller with the extension. Why do you use this concept? If I want to use standard controller and a controller together, we have a concept of extension. If you want to use standard controller and a controller together, we have a concept of extension. Now at the same time, I have a requirement like this. Look at this point. On the contact object, on a record, I want to give a button here. Send email. When I click on that button, email should go to the corresponding customer. Do you have any button called send email? No. What you want to do? Create your own button. Add that button on standard page. If it is a custom page, VF page with Apex class, I can do it. But what is your intention? You want to add extra button on standard page. Whatever the pages Salesforce has created, on those standard pages, I want to add extra button here. So creating a custom logics on standard pages. Now what is your intention? When I click on the button, we can click on the button. When you click on the button, when I click on the button, it has to send. Now, see, now we are working with a metadata or a data. Are you working with a metadata or a data? Metadata is what? Object, fields in the object, data type of the object, properties, who has permission, who don't have permission. Now I am working with what? Data in the table. When you write a query, are you getting a metadata or a data? Now we are creating a button on a record or on a table. When you record, the button is getting spread. Now we are working with what? Data. Now deletion of fields, all this stuff will come with the metadata. Data in the table, whatever the data is there, we are working with the data in the table. Right. Okay. Let's go to the next one. Now, I'm giving it public. Giving public what I want to do. Standard control. Apex page dot standard controller control. Now we are referring to the contact. The first point is get the record. Whenever I say get the record, get the record will give the record with when I say get record will get the record with only ID field. Apart from the ID, if you want any other fields from the record, when you say get record, it will give the record with ID only. Apart from ID, if you want any other fields, whichever the fields you want, create. What are the fields you want? Create them like array and add controller dot what was that? Boss, when you say controller dot add fields, generally it takes only ID field. Apart from ID, if you want anything else, 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 then we are supposed to create an array of fields and say controller dot add fields. We are supposed to create array of fields and say controller dot add fields. Controller dot add fields. I hope you are good. People are good with this. Controller dot add fields. Then, what is your intention? How do you create it? We want to send an email. I am giving one example as sending email. As per your requirement, you can design your logic. So I say I'm giving. So I'm giving some some message I'm giving here. This I created some message here, some random message I've created. Then I want to set it as a body. This is what we have created. What was that? This structure I gave. Now, what I was supposed to do? Create a VF page. Standard controller extensions. The moment you click on the button, action I want to perform. What is the action? Once you send the email, right, once you send email, come back to the same page. Now I hope you are good with this. The primary point here is, when I say get record, only ID will come. If you want any other data from that record, we are supposed to add those fields to controller. So whichever the record from where I am clicking, whichever the record from where I am clicking the button, that record will come as a controller. From whichever the record we are clicking the button, from that record will be coming as a controller. So in that controller, what data will come? Only ID will come. Apart from ID, if you want any other data, add those fields to controller. Rest of the program is same. Now the biggest question is, how do you create a button on the contact? So look at this. Setup, build, customize, we have contacts, buttons, links and actions, new button. New button. Do you want to display like a link or a button? I want to display like a button. Where? On the detail page of the... Now, when you click on the button, do you want me to open a new window? No need of any new window. Open in the existing window. Now, do you want to open any URL or JavaScript or Visual Force? Look at this. Only these three pages came. Why? Because only these three pages are using standard control equal to contact. We have created our own button. Now, once you have created a button, button will not be displayed on the page layout. What should I do? Go to the page layout. Go to buttons. Email. Select the button. Whatever the button you have created, add it. Now we are able to see. Now, when I clicked on the button, let me see. So we have this, how we got the alert. I hope you are good with this. What I was trying to do was, if you want to create your own buttons on the standard pages, or you want to replace any one of the standard functionality on the standard functionalities, then we are supposed to go with one of the concept as extension. Extension means standard controller extending its concept with the custom logic. When you say standard controller, we are using the standard functionalities. Along with the standard functionalities, I want to go for my custom logic. That is the reason we are going for extension. In the extension, we are going with the FX pages dot standard controller. Whenever I say FX pages dot standard controller, FX pages dot standard controller will refer to only one record. FX pages dot standard controller will refer to any one record. FX pages dot standard controller will refer to any one of the records. let me explain. No. I give this. Now I'm giving apex page dot standard controller. So apex pages dot standard controller is referring to any one record. Apex pages dot standard controller is referring to any one record. Here I am passing that ACC in that program. In that program, from whichever the page you click the button, that record is coming. From whichever the page I am calling this apex class, that record is set. Here what did I do? I created my own record, I passed it. But in the program, what is happening? Whichever the record, from a contact record, I clicked on a button. So whichever the contact record I clicked, that record is passed as a standard controller. Now, from VF page, I clicked on a button. Whichever the VF page I have chosen, from that VF page, the data what I entered is taken as a controller. Are you getting my point? Right. In this controller, what we have? We have controller.sit. It will save the record. Controller.edit. It will take you to edit page of the record. Controller.delete. It will delete the record. It will give the ID of the record. Get record. It will give the record. Controller.add. If you want to add any fields, can. So what was that? Controller means that record. On that record, save. On that record, edit. On that record, delete. On that record, get the ID. On that record, get the record. On that record, add the fields. Are you getting? What is that apex pages dot standard controller? The apex pages dot standard controller is going to refer to one record of anything that you pass, any one record. That record you want to save, controller dot save. Edit, controller dot edit. Delete, controller dot delete. View, controller dot view. I hope you are getting my point. You want to get the ID of the record, controller dot get ID. You want to get the fields, controller dot add fields, any extra fields. Right. So what is the purpose of apex pages dot standard controller? It will refer to any one record. Now in this case, which record is coming? From the, I am clicking this button from where? From a particular record. Whichever the record from where I clicked, from this record I clicked, this record will be passed as a controller. Here I told accounts. So the data what I am entering in this page, that is, that record is taken as controller. So controller.getRecord, controller. Now apex pages dot standard controller will save the data in the form of what? SA object. Why SA object? Because I am not sure what type of record you are going to give. Okay, second point. Now basically what is the purpose of extension? Standard properties. I have standard properties. Along with that, some of the standard properties I want to replace. I want to define some of the extra properties. If you want to define your own functionality along with the standard functionalities, then you go with the standard controller with the extension. Any Apex class you want to take as an extension, the class should have constructor with the parameter. What is the parameter? Apex pages dot standard controller. Apex pages dot standard set controller. Apex pages dot standard set controller. Apex pages dot standard controller. Or apex pages dot standard set controller. Standard controller means one record. Standard set controller means group of record. That we'll discuss in the next session. Right. I hope you are good with this. Tell me one of the purpose of this extension. You want to replace any one of the existing functionalities defined by Salesforce. You want to build any extra functionality on standard pages. then we go for a concept of extension. I hope you are good with this. Everyone has followed? One key point. How many classes we can define as an extension? Generally, how many classes we can define as a controller? Only one class. We can define multiple classes as extension. If you take, how many objects I can define as standard controller? One object. How many classes I can define as controller? Only one class. How many classes I can define as extension? Multiple number of classes. I can define more than one class as an extension. We have a choice of defining more than one apex class as an extension. I hope you are good. Any query on that? Clear? That's all for mine. And we'll have a session.